Good morning to all those tuning in. This is the Web of Lemon, and today we're back to playing the Night of the Rabbit. So, last time we left off, we got our journey started, and we ended up finding a chest that appeared out of nowhere. So, without any further ado, why don't we get right back into the game? So, I've actually been enjoying this game so far, and I really can't wait for the story to continue, honestly. What?
Mom says there used to be important trails, but today you can only...
Oh, okay. I guess I just have to do the ritual again.
Okay, that should do.
I don't know why it saved after the, before the ritual was done, but, I mean, we get the cool cutscene again, so I'm not gonna complain. And now?
Nuts, they said. There's no such thing as magic, they said. They're all in their words.
And there we go. We're now a magician.
The great Zara experienced the greatest illusionist of our time, but it doesn't say when or where the show is. How strange. The poster looks pretty old, too. I wonder if the trunk here belonged to Zara. I'll just take one of the posters. Oh, there's a rip in the lining of the trunk lid. Great Zarov. I wonder if that was his stuff in the trunk. His top hat.
Interesting. Our journal also got updated. So, a strange glade, a legendary tree, a figure dressed in black, and a traveler's case. How mysterious. Jerry's greatest dream is becoming a magician while he's asleep, growing red eyes watch him in the night. Only 2 days of summer vacation left, adventure ho, and possible traveler's case appeared in the clearing. What is behind all this? Alright.
It's packed full of equipment for a magic show. It says the Great Zara on the poster. Is this his stuff? His top hat?
Why not take it?
Whoa, holy cow, what? Again?
They actually really do.
Well, a little rip is no big deal. That's easy to repair.
And why would you rip it more?
Hey, there's a magic wand in the lining. It almost looks like somebody did it there.
Not very well. Wait, do we use the wand on the hat?
Top hat and magic wand. All right, Jerry, the time has come. You've been training for this for years. So, Abraca.
Since I last drank a carrot flame. Ah, permit me to introduce myself. I am the Marquis, the Marquis de Hoto.
Oh, but you're...
Auriculus cuniculus sapiens, yes, indeed.
Well, I'm Jeremiah.
Jeremiah Hazelnut, the boy with the dream. I know much more than that. Your summer vacation ends the day after tomorrow.
That's right, but unfortunately.
Mathematics, leaky pens, hard wooden benches, dry chalk dust. You human children are so brave, yet you dream of more. The murmur of the leaves in the wind, it reminds me of home.
Where's that?
My home? It's where I'm remembered.
Yes, but where exactly?
I can
scarcely
remember.
What?
Jerry, tell me, what's your greatest dream?
Huh. Well, first off, that's, pulling a rabbit out of the hat, I guess. I practice magic tricks in my free time, but...
I want to be a magician.
I know, for I am a magician. Beloved, feared, needed, and extremely brilliant.
My goodness.
Will you be my apprentice?
What? Absolutely!
Travel with me. Beyond the boundaries of the imaginable. Study the five fiery mantras of the Phoenix Conjuration and master every single facet of magic. Well, not all of that.
This is fantastic, but... My mother says I have to be home for dinner.
Jerry. Your training will take days, weeks.
Such a long time, of course.
Such a long time, of course.
True training in the magical disciplines, the study of the art of arts, all of this takes time.
Then I probably won't be able to.
And even time itself is an object of study for magicians. He who studies time needs time.
Okay.
Oh no.
But Jerry, listen to me. Forget impossible. For a magician, nothing is impossible. On a day in summer vacation, anything is possible. I promise you that you'll be back in time for dinner. You carry a certain coin.
What? How do you know that?
It has a very special aura.
Where did you get it? I don't know exactly. It seems like I've always had it.
Don't worry, Jem. Everything which is lost will turn.
I always used to practice my magic tricks with it.
Look through the hole in your coin. Its magic power will grant you a new view of the world. What you'll see is magical iridescence. From now on, the coin will show you what might be helpful in your training.
To look through the magic coin and see things that are invisible to the naked eye, open the inventory and click on the coin. You can press the spacebar or the middle mouse button anytime. Okay.
Time for dinner. You will need this.
Hey.
Jerry, do you remember what I told you?
Nothing is impossible.
And soon it will no longer sound like a question when you say it.
Wait!
What the hell?
Do you know this place, Jerry?
Sure, that's your part of it.
I am sure that you have sensed that this is a special place.
Special?
Magic. It's easy to get lost in places like this.
Hey, I'm not a little kid anymore.
Even adults can become lost in the woods. Do you sense?
I hear a rumbling.
Use your coin, Jerry.
Alright, so we press the middle mouse button or space. Okay, so it does work.
Oh man, a toad! It's gigantic!
The magic in this place allows it to survive here and grow, forgotten by time. But just as with any other power, magic too can be misused, like the power of this portal. Then you enter.
Me?
The magicians, the tree walkers.
I thought I was a magician's apprentice.
Tree walkers? I thought I was a magician's apprentice.
We tree walkers use magic portal trees to travel back and forth between different worlds.
Different worlds?
Places, times, and possibilities form an almost infinite number of worlds. You will be trained by me in the tradition of the tree walkers and acquire this ancient knowledge of walking between the worlds.
Sounds complicated.
It's quite easy, almost like riding a bicycle.
Really?
No. At worst, it feels as if you're being ground to a powder between two contradictions.
I don't understand.
None of us do, but you'll learn quickly.
Sounds maddening.
Portal tree? What does that mean?
Portal trees are trees with roots that reach deep into the fabric of reality. So deeply that they exist in more than one place and time, creating magical connections. Some use these connections to move back and forth among the worlds. As do we tree walkers.
But how do you use a portal tree?
But how do you use a portal tree?
This is where magic begins. Go through the portal, Jerry. From now on, casting magic and wandering between worlds will be an important part of your life.
Isn't it dangerous? I mean... Hey! Whoa!
Someone is hurt. Four nails. Hurry. We shall ride the wind. As we have always done.
I am so confused in what's going on. Oh.
Still looks like the woods we have back at home. And somehow...
Here we are.
But that's a... With a backpack.
The farther we go from the portal tree, the more clearly you will come to realize that we have left the world you know far behind us. Only the parallels here at the portal tree suggest a connection. Such as this wall. Follow me, Jeremiah Hazelnut.
Hey, it's him again. Interesting.
I promised you magic. Another world. Before you, Jerry, lies Mousewood.
Wow!
Here you will complete your trip.
But where's the school? And all the teachers' lives?
This world was born magical. Its trees send their roots deep into the earth and create connections like the one we use together. This world will be your school, and its inhabitants will teach you many things. This place may seem cruel, but soon it will be an important part of your life. Then, once your training is complete, you will see the world with the eyes of a tree walker. So follow me, young hazelnut.
Oh, wait.
Oh, all the way back there. I will say I have noticed that the character models, especially in cutscenes, is a little rigid. Which is fine.
I know this must still be overwhelming to you, but I need a moment. Just wait here. I'll be right back. I'm going to announce you to the town council.
All right.
Wow. Being this small is really interesting. Who would have thought of massive towns? Well, hey!
Alright. The Marquis went to Mousewood Town Hall, introducing Jerry to the town council. He asked Jerry to wait, so stay a while and talk to some folks. Young squirrel. Sure.
A hoard in the middle of the square. Maybe you can use it to call someone.
Oh, a cafe. Okay, let's talk to the people outside first.
Excuse me, but no time. Gotta practice. There's a birthday party this evening at the Hares. And I'm prepping to go. Well, hey!
Sure. Whatever you say.
What a strange looking squirrel. He looks so daring. Like he has a lot of stories to tell.
Daring? Don't you see all these maps? What?
Oh, so you're a map maker.
Hardly. I'm a traveler. Is this your first time in Mousewood? Come see me later. Just walk up the ramp to the right of the tunnel.
Oh, cool.
Just leave and lose a chance to become a magician? No way.
Jerry something has large mouth one to go with the training. Oh, Martique's still hotel. A wizard and tree walker. Wants to make Jerry his apprentice. He promises the boy to make be back till dinner, blah blah blah. Yeah.
Hello? Is everything okay?
Who's there? Is there someone behind me?
I've been haunted by a ghost.
I don't think you are. At least I don't see
it. I can't see anyone either, but I know something's there. Understand a single word, and then they stick you with a ghost. Isn't that just typical? I get all the luck.
The backpack mouse thinks there's someone shadowing him, someone invisible. Can you see anyone? Oh! Hey, he's back.
Ah, there you are. Come, Jerry. I want to introduce you to someone.
Please excuse this sudden trespass, honored owl and squirrel.
Ah, Jonathan. This is the rabbit I was just...
But that's dormouse. Those eyes. Eyes that have seen countless worlds. Some say he knows no mercy, but my parents said he was one of the first tree walkers.
I was not the first, but I knew him.
The Marquis de Hoto. I was barely knee-high to a grasshopper the last time I saw you.
In accordance with the tradition of the tree walkers, I hereby present you my apprentice, Jeremiah Hazelnut. I am here to request support for him, so that he may learn the art of arts in these woods.
Ah, magic, of course. I should have guessed that right away. So this nestling is a new magician's apprentice, and we thought the tradition of the tree walkers had been lost.
Magician's apprentice, please hold your horseflies for a moment, Jonathan.
Certainly not. Tradition demands that we immediately prepare the treetop festival. A new tree walker must be celebrated properly.
According to tradition, the apprentice must make the preparations for the treetop festival alone.
Nestling, before your training begins, you must send out invitations and order the blue juice and baked goods for the festival.
Precisely.
You should speak to Anya Mouse. She is the very best baker here, Mousewood.
I shall wait for you here, Jerry. I'm interested in what's happened here. Mousewood has changed.
Does that mean I'm supposed to run around out there all by myself?
I trust that you can take care of yourself. It's still summer vacation. This is your adventure, Jerry. You think you could do it?
Absolutely.
What was with that pause?
Stop! Don't step on the books.
Shouldn't somebody tidy them up?
That's what I'm doing. But Conrad's niece, Ursula, keeps fixing them up again.
Huh?
I always tell people that Rose paws the mess, and Ursula makes sure that it stays that way.
Cute.
Tricky of impractical reason by Emmanuel. History by Hildegard of Beehive. Oh, where shall I put that?
How about sorting the books by topic? Brainy stuff here, nature stuff there.
That is exactly what I am doing. Here are those with a red cover, and over there is where those with green covers would go.
Are you sure that's a good idea?
But of course. Then you can find the red books immediately when you look for them. I mean, no one ever reads the green ones. Anyway, weird stuff that is. In Dicenaria, they didn't have green books at all.
Jonathan, you've never even been there.
Of course I have. But naturally, it was during a reading tour.
As you can see, young man, Jonathan's sorting skills are just as dreadful as his sense of humor.
I get to laugh now and then, can't hurt.
You know, I like the two of them. They're cute together. Oh yeah, these two.
May I bother you for a second?
No, I'm working.
What are you working on?
Trade.
That is staring into space.
I am thinking and planning.
What is there to plan?
We must replenish our stores. A crow must have feasted in here during the evacuation. For months, our beautiful Mousewood has been subjected to aggressive crow attacks. Those crows are feral, almost incapable of speaking. Ooh, very unsettling situation.
See, I find that weird since crows are some of the smartest animals. In at least our world? Time to go to the bakery. Or at least cafe, but they typically have baked goods anyways.
It sure smells good in here. Kind of like pearl drops. Huh?
Okay. That's fascinating. It tells us everything we can interact with.
There's a note hanging there. One of our guests left the cheese wheel behind. Since it's been here for 3 years, all guests may now help themselves freely. Kindest regards, Anya. Free? Super! Oh man, the cheese is rock hard.
Okay, so I need something to get
right
at it. Yeah, just don't say anything.
I'm already here, honey dripper.
That is adorable.
No. That would be good.
Sink.
One hot coffee. That won't work. I'd better leave that where it is. I want to be a magician, not a key thief. Around here, they probably sentence you to 1,000 laps of the hamster wheel.
I would be a little more careful with what you say.
I bet it, I won't.
You still won't take
around
it?
It says, coffee, free. But please, please also try our pound cake. One hot coffee.
Do you not know how to make a coffee?
One hot cup. That won't work.
I want a coffee right now.
That. It's off. No reception.
We're off the air.
Cool mushroom. The way it smells in here, the pots must contain dried herbs and spices.
No shit.
My friend.
Wait a second. I know that voice.
Ludwig Borrower is the name. Swamp Radio 103.6, 5. Mole in the morning, mole at noon, and mole in the evening.
Right. I heard you on the radio once.
Yes. Unfortunately, the swamp path is still flooded, so I can't. Lovely. I've been broadcasting from the swamp ever since the crows pulled apart my old transmitter.
So you are radio DJ? Any hope of transmitting soon? Always want to be on the radio too.
So you're a radio DJ?
Yes. Unfortunately, the swamp path is still flooded, so I'd love to broadcast. I've been broadcasting from the swamp ever since the crows pulled apart my old transmitter. Swamp Radio 103.6, 5. Mole in the morning, mole at and.
Yeah, we know.
Is there any hope that you'll be transmitting again soon?
With all the moisture that creeps into my transmitter in the swamp? Never! Someone might complain about my watered-down contributions.
What? But your fans?
They'll say my jokes are all wet.
How will you explain to your fans that you're quitting?
With damp eyes.
Because everything's flooded, right?
No, because it's really so.
No, you can't just give up like that.
But I'm not giving up. Crack a nut, squirrel, as the young people say these days. No, to get me to stop broadcasting, they'll have to climb my arms, legs, mouth, and belly button.
I'm not gonna question that one.
I've always wanted to be on the radio too.
That's the right attitude. If you want to host with me, you'll have to be sharp.
Sharp?
Yes. Just try to set him up so I can knock him down. With rapier-like wit.
What should I say?
Oh, something funny.
Oh. Okay. Well, why did the chicken cross the road?
That's not good. That'll go down very badly here in Mousewood.
Oh, okay.
Try to come up with something more appropriate for our audience. Try again.
I have to be going.
See you soon. And remember, Swamp Radio 103.6, 5. Mole in the mole and...
Yeah, you get it. Let's talk to the lady behind the counter now.
Dry tea cakes and runny custard. Just a sec. Well, my name is Anna. Welcome to my little tree trunk cafe.
Hello, I'm Jerry.
Oh, you're sweet as sugar.
Just now. That sounded dangerous.
But of course. Dangerous and tasty. Uncreating something. Exploding cookies.
Yeah, but wouldn't an exploding cake be better?
Trust me, sugar cube. Pancake-tastic. I hope the boy I'm babysitting will have real fun with them. Little Humbert is a bit different. Everyone thinks he's a nasty, spoiled brat, but he's just under-challenged. Gifted child. Maybe my new cookies will keep him on his toes.
As far as that under-challenged Humbert goes, have you found an interesting hobby for Humbert?
Not yet, alas.
Oh, too
bad.
I'm always asking other people questions. No one ever asked me a question.
Oh, that's terrible. You poor pumpkin. Would you like me to ask you a question?
Yeah, ask one.
Have you seen a frog on your travels? Big fella. Really good looking. He usually drinks coffee here about this time. But he hasn't come in yet.
And I thought we were talking about me.
Wait, I think I do know him.
See you later.
You know what? I actually like her. So far, I think she might be one of my favorite characters. And I actually have to go back in so I can talk to the person with the backpack.
The door is now open.
Oh my god.
This is private property. Get it out.
Uh-oh.
I guess we just wait for the mouse.
There's a sign. Roof terrace closed. Danger of abduction by crows. That doesn't sound good.
Remember, there are no problems. Only challenges.
You're out there somewhere. Come back soon. I'll take care of your guard until then.
Okay. Wasn't very helpful. Alright, what do we have? Poster, the book.
The mouse with the backpack gave it to me. It's full of writing I can't read. I wonder whether it belongs to that mysterious wood sprite.
Oh, we have the wand now. And the coin. Interesting. We have a book, small sign. Oh, what's up here? I would have never known about that.
Hello, why are you up here?
I was assigned to Canada Duke. We had a big crow drop here. Well, and we even had to evacuate the town.
That sounds horrible.
Well, it was. So if I see one of those horrid creatures, then kaboom! Usually I fly out the northwest. I have to keep my eyes open all the time, even at night. Paws off! The cannon has to be ready for the next crow attack. Imagine a critter like that flying right into the town hall. Again, usually I fly out the northwest. I have to keep my eyes open all the time, even at night.
Can't do that from here. Can't do that from here. Can't do that from here.
Huh, okay, so we can't do anything over there. Oh, that's the other way.
Hello, Mr. Squirrel.
Everyone, it's
interesting.
The bats in my backpack, the beauty of nature is manifested in its subtlest, most delightful way in these other worlds. Yes, I'm on an enormous adventure, and it begins here at home, in our humble cold water brook.
Oh, that sounds exciting. But why are you on your way? That much ocean must take an awfully long time to explore.
Tell me about it. I wanted to complete the first leg of the traditional Mousewood leaflet. I ordered it from the hedge clubs. They are the most talented and reliable craftspeople here in the woods. All they had to do was float the boat down the cold water brook. But I've been waiting here for a while now. You wouldn't have to be heading to a pumpkin patch on the edge of town, would you? If you could ask about my boat at the Hedgehog Brothers workshop,
no problem. I'll take care of it.
I talked to hedgehogs.
This owl statue looks incredibly wise. It must have seen all kinds of things swim, float, and gurgle past in the brook.
Oh.
Securely locked.
Shame. Owl statue. Oh, it's...
Therefore, I can only
Interesting. Alright, well, let's head back in the town. And then... I guess let's leave town for now. And we can talk with the guards out here.
Hey, who are you? I've never seen you here before.
Nonsense. You came for here earlier today.
Yeah?
Yeah, together with a rabbit with weird red eyes.
Well, I remember that one.
I'm Jerry Hazelnut, magician in training.
Magician? You? I might have bought that for your friend with the red eyes, but...
I mean, that's your job. Kind of what you do.
Another statue. It looks like those stone eyes have seen a lot. This statue looks like a mouse, like a grumpy city guy. Faced with something like that, you feel a lot more cheerful yourself. Some company that is for the real gods.
So we have that way. Way through the grass.
In Mousewood, it says to the cold water brook bridge, but it looks like gold dookies. It says to the path through other women. We call it the same thing.
Well, you call it that, I'm guessing, because that's what, the rabbit described it as.
Oh, you're in Mousewood too. How funny.
Oh yeah, he is.
The little hair statue isn't so little here.
Huh. Interesting.
There's an owl's wall here too, just like at home.
Everything's the same but different.
Wait, I know you, or at least someone who's just as lazy as you.
I actually want to talk to the frog that was on the other side of the portal. Also, just like in general, check some more stuff out.
Weird statue. There's a little stone face in the crystal. There's some kind of amber thing. I can find sound. Very, very soft. Looks like a thick glass.
Interesting.
It's much, much deeper than it is back home. Good thing I'm a decent swimmer.
Did you know most people don't know how to swim? I didn't know that until a little bit ago.
Whoa, that is a big spider. Holy cow! As long as it stays right there, it can keep its pretty spider web.
Let's kill it with a stick.
I don't want to make a spider mad, and if the web breaks, it's no good to anybody.
Interesting.
Who would have thought the old path tree? Maybe in the olden days, someone actually knew about the portal.
Okay, so... I thought that we could maybe head back to the other side and chat with the toad that was over there. But I guess not. And seeing as there's not much here, we'll just head back to town and maybe try and go the other way. Oh, creepy.
Something written on this one next to it. Talk to one another, deal with one another, live with one another. In remembrance of the regular meetings held in this brook to reconcile the differences between mice, squirrels, and other inhabitants of the woods. Other inhabitants? I guess that would include me if I lived there. There's something written on the stone next to it. Talk to one of the...
Oh, yeah. No. So that's that. Weird brook. Path through the field.
Hold, he'll go there. What sort of hideous beast are you?
Ouch.
I just need to get past you for a second.
Yeah, sure.
What's the problem?
No problem. Just pay 500 lead bucks. Now, that's what it costs if you want to cross the cold water from the creek. That's how much the troll costs.
You mean toll?
No, I mean troll. Being supporting for those of us who don't make mistakes.
If we did that, the whole world might go silent.
Everybody but me, that's right.
Huh?
And maybe my babysitter Anya. She says I'm an extremely gifted child. Mm. I can stand her, more or less.
Well, awful. But how can we possibly negotiate if I'm not supposed to talk?
Fine. 300 leaf bucks.
300 leaf bucks? Oh, right. You must be a government official if you will this kind of authority. Is there a magician's apprentice discount by any chance? Normally, magician's apprentices get financial aid. I have to cross the bridge for educational purposes.
Educational purposes? Discount? Be glad you have the opportunity to get through here at all. 300 leaf bucks, that's the fee. Pay up or stay on your side of the bridge. It's no loss to us.
I'll be back later. What? Rachel, cut from it. I can't get into a fight with a little kid. I'm just too good-natured. I have to find a way to get over the bridge without dangling him over the side by one leg to teach him a lesson.
I don't know. I think I would do it. Dangle him over the edge, or even just shove him in. Because fuck it, it'd be funny. I think I just need one of these.
Sorry, but I'd rather not.
Let's talk to, Anya again.
Just a sec.
Because she's the one who mentioned the kid she babysits for. And we just met that kid.
Aww.
I do like how she talks, though. It's really nice. I could listen to someone talk like that for a long time. Let's go up here.
Nice garden.
Just look with your eyes. No touching.
Oh.
The mouse walks around totally lost in thought. What a sturdy looking wraith. It probably belongs to the hare family.
Hey, you. What are you doing with our family friend?
I'm just borrowing it for a moment. Last night the wind blew all these leaves onto our lawn.
Oh, yeah. Oh, off you go. Those leaves aren't going to rake themselves.
Oh, it's kind of nice of them. I am surprised that we got away with that, though.
Hey, you. Everything okay?
I know how that is.
Somebody's shirking dish duty.
I'm meditating.
That's a lot of mailboxes.
There's a lot of room in our house. And a lot of pears. We have even more tunnels than the woods, of course. 23 of them.
nice garden.
This is private property.
Okay, okay.
Jeez. Why is he so moody?
What a strange statue. He had a heart to it, and now it no longer has eyes. Memo, we need more blue juice. Well, the barrel looks empty, but the tap is still being used.
Oh, now we can... I wonder if now we can get the coffee. Either that or I'm just crazy, but hey, worth a try. I can't believe we lied about...
Nothing needs to be tapped from there.
Alright, fine. Have it your way. Well, might as well look around the town then. We still have, what, one more pathway?
You can see into the town hall from here. The old squirrel, Jonathan, has already seen me. He's waving his cane. I think he's afraid I'll climb in through the window and walk all over his books. I'd never do that. At least, not while someone's looking. A sad human face behind ivy. I wondered who painted that.
That is actually a good question.
What a weird statue. There's a little stone face in the crystal. And some kind of amber thing.
Again? Huh.
Wow, the whole town fits under the tree. Any bird who built a nest up on a branch would have a magnificent view. They smell earthy. I like mushrooms a lot better like this than in mum's salads. Ugh. Hello, I'm Jerry. Junior? Hello? Junior?
Please shut up. Step right up and admire the goods, but make sure that your eyes stay in your head. Although, that wouldn't be a problem, because we have outstanding glass eyes on all the things you can buy here at ridiculously low prices. Ridiculously low. At Church Mouse and Son.
Glass eyes?
And much more. The travelling merchants, Church Mouse and Son, everything you've ever wanted, will want, and will need. Even though you don't know you want it, will want it, or will need to have one.
You talk like an actor.
Funny you should say that, but let's get down to business. What do you mean? Church Mouse and Son have everything.
I'm looking for something tasty. Maple syrup cheesecake. With walnuts?
Even better. A mud pie with twigs and rocks in the shape of a heart.
Mud pie? Ugh. Thanks, but no thanks.
It's very realistic. Mud fans know what I'm talking about. Isn't that right, Junior? He'll be taking over the whole shop soon. And then I'll take a well-earned retirement. Soon you can sell your own mud pies. But a terribly good businessman. I believe in him really, really strong. You hear? Junior? It's so nice to know that you're golden. Well, then you take this one time only, small but exquisite promotional gift. A red thread. Here, let me tie the thread to your amusing round coin. Which, by the way, will not be accepted as payment.
Very decorative. Thanks.
The high quality red thread I gave you should lead you back to Church Mouse and Son for whenever you need exquisite things. Things of every kind. Pretty things, tall things, small things. White things, bright things, filled things, spilled things, things with sugar, things with mud.
Yeah.
Silly things. Okay. If you're looking for things, come to Church Mountain South. Don't take too long. Soon I'll be handing my business over to my talented son, so that I can retire to the Coconut Palm Islands. We're still saving up enough money for the trip. Isn't that right, Junior? Yeah.
Thank you. I'll be sure to come in if I need...
things.
Need things.
Well, we have stuff, too.
All right, things and stuff.
And junk.
Things, stuff, and junk.
Now you've got it.
I don't know. I have a feeling Junior is not among the living.
Oh, it's you. Boy with a hat. I first realized. What do you need? Church Mouse and Son have everything.
Action figures. Play outside.
Is there anything to play?
Maybe these helicopters from an antique set of toy soldiers just might be you. They're green and look like propellers. One side is sticky and you can stick it to your nose.
Those must be helicopter seeds from a maple tree. An antique seed that's still green. If they're more than 2 days old, then you've discovered the secret of eternal youth. Well, how much do they cost?
A mere 2 leaf bucks per helicopter. And if you buy 5, I'll toss in this extraordinarily well-preserved stick.
Well...
And there's this single sock with the embroidered initials RT. What's your name?
Jerry Hazelnut.
Well, RD. Merry days, all right. Looks like a seed in a pot.
But I don't have that much money.
Oh. We are almost in business. Negotiating skills are important, son. He'll be taking over the whole shop soon. And then I'll take a well-earned retirement. Soon you'll be able to make unbeatable offers to our customers yourself. Yeah. But a terribly good businessman. Believe in him. Really, really. Julian?
Yeah. I'm just... Yeah, I think Junior's dead. Oh well.
Then use it for someone.
Then use it.
Use it for someone. Something about this pumpkin is different. It's round and big and orange.
No shit.
Can't put my finger on it. But something about it is different.
On thread. I don't know. Hit it with a stick.
A stick won't help here.
I tried my best. All out of ideas. 'Twas only violence.
You'd have to be about half my size to fit through there.
Large pumpkin. Tree. Oh, wooden board. Oh, those are the hedgehogs.
It'll be okay. We'll find your mummy. Wow, what a big leaf.
That's a leaf bug for Mr. Spitz, then.
Unfortunately, we haven't finished.
Oh, up there. The hive with honey. Crow statue. Pumpkin.
It says, A. Molina. No advertisements, please. How mysterious. Strange. And locked.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter, it seems, if they Well, people say no advertisements. People put them in there anyways. It's kind of annoying.
Are you the Hedgehog Brothers?
Oh, we are.
I'm Jerry, Magician's Apprentice. Mr. Spitzweg sent me to ask about his boat.
Ah, Spitzweg's probably been waiting at the catfish barrier for hours. I bet there's a green hat behind him.
Ah, don't be silly.
Our dad told us about green hats.
We were 4 years old.
What? Stop! Oh no, the thief is gone.
Oh.
I have to go after him.
Oh yeah, let's go. He went through the log.
The little man in green. There he is again.
Ah, first of the hedgehogs. And now me. You've got the wrong man. I've done nothing. Confounded, Billy. I mean, got to the weaver, of course, it comes to you.
He's gone again. He seemed pretty angry.
Let's continue following him. Oh, I did notice the mouse in the back. Go to the weasel. That the mouse in the back looks like the guy on the cannon. Hey!
The Shabrock Ripper certainly won't find me here.
There he is again. Stop!
Ha. I'm standing on a shamrock. It's magic. Gives me strength. I can do whatever I like here.
Edge of town. Okay.
Johnny Cox and Fly Specs. Here's the impatient brat. You'll never get me, Shamrock.
Huh.
There's not even one bee inside. But judging by the sweet smell, the bee's only just left.
What if we got some honey? No, not sweetened. Could we? Oh, tap. No shit.
Nothing needs to be tapped.
Huh.
Nothing.
Old Finch, pick it. I know, I have an idea of what to do, and I think it has something to do with laying a trap here.
Nice garden.
Just look with your eyes. Don't touch it.
The mouse walks
around. Signs, cafe, pretty flower.
Have you seen Pt.2 the frog lady?
Yeah, same thing.
Excuse me, I've got a problem. There's a problem. Where?
Yeah, same thing from him, too. What's in our journal? A little man dressed in green snagged the hedgehog with his tools. But there's probably a way to bribe him. Yeah, we have a bunch of little missions. I don't exactly know what to do, granted. Poster, mysterious book. Well, I don't know about you, but we'll give it a quick save. Yeah, be fine. Back. And I guess we'll just end it there for now. I need to figure. So I got a few missions to do now that I'm in Mousewood. I got the chance to explore it all. And yeah. So I know I need to trap the leprechaun somehow. Or the green hat, they call it. That will get me the tools to fix the bow, which will allow me to talk to Spritzwood. I need to bribe the little shit that is blocking the way. And I need blue juice. So I guess we will start to figure out that kind of stuff in the next episode. But until then, thank you for tuning into The Frequency. This is the Rebel Lemon, signing off. So, good night and sweet nightmares.